Još jednom želim Boži blagoslov svima vama. Hvala vam što ste došli. Neka vas Gospod danas blagoslovi zajedno sa svima nama.
Once again, I wish you God's blessings and I welcome you to our church and I hope that we can be blessed together and learn from God's word.
Nemam mnogo vremena, tako da ne gubim na pozdrave. Idemo da razmišljamo o jednoj vrlo važnoj temi.
So let's get straight into our topic.
Danas želimo da razmišljamo o danu naše slave.
Today I'd like to talk about the day of our glorification.
O čemu se tu radi?
What's this all about?
Ili mnogi ljudi pitaju da li vredi da sledimo našeg Gospoda Isusa.
Many people ask themselves, is it worth it to follow Jesus?
Šta mi dobijamo time što sledimo Gospoda Isusa Hrista?
What do we gain from following Jesus Christ?
I mnogi imaju odgovor šta nam Isus čini danas.
And many answer with things that Jesus does for us today, here and now.
Ali danas ćemo pričati o tome šta je Isus pripremio za svoju vernu decu.
But I want to talk about what Jesus has prepared in the future for his children.
Dan Isusovog dolaska će biti za nas dan naše slave.
The day of Jesus' second coming will be the day of our glorification.
I zato mi vidite dubokom čežnjom čekamo Hristov dolazak.
And that's why we deeply desire Christ's coming.
Mi imamo ličnog razloga da se radujemo Hristovom dolasku.
We have reasons to be personally joyful at the thought of Christ's return.
Ja sam skupio to blago u mom srcu.
I have gathered up this wealth in my heart.
Ali želim da danas podelim te dijamante sa svima vama.
But I'd like to share these diamonds with you today.
Hajde da se pomolimo Bogu.
Let's pray together.
Oče dragi.
Dear Father.
Hvala ti što ćemo moći da čitamo tvoju reč.
Thank you that we'll be able to read your word.
Molimo te prosvetli naš razum.
We pray that you would enlighten our minds.
Da možemo razumeti tvoja obećanja.
So that we'd be able to understand your promises.
Daj nam i vere da ih možemo prihvatiti.
Give us faith to accept your promises.
Daj nam i sile Svetoga Duha.
Give us the power of the Holy Spirit.
Da nas posveti istinom tvojom.
To show us your truth.
Nahrani duše svih nas koji smo danas ovde pred tobom.
Lord, we ask that you would feed the souls of each person here.
Molimo te u Gospoda. U ime Gospoda našega Isusa Hrista.
We pray this in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
Dakle, Petar je pitao našeg Gospoda.
So Peter asked our Lord.
Evo, mi te sledimo i šta će biti s nama?
We are following you, but what will become of us?
I Gospod mu je odgovorio, sećate se.
And the Lord answered and said.
I to što je Gospod njemu odgovorio, ja želim danas da delim sa vama.
He said words which I want to share with you this morning.
Hajde da prvo pročitamo Rimljanima 2:7.
Let's read Romans 2:7.
Onima koji istrajno čine dobro,
God will give eternal life.
A tražeći slavu, čast i neraspadljivost,
to those who keep on doing good.
Daće večni život.
They want glory, honor and life that never ends.
Dakle, mi smo ti koji činimo dobro.
We are those who do good.
Mi tražimo slavu.
We are seeking glory.
A mi tražimo, dakle, neraspadljivost.
We're seeking an incorruptible life that
to
never
je Bog
ends.
Stavio u naše srce.
That's something that God has put in our hearts.
A vrhunac svega toga je večni život.
And the pinnacle of all this is eternal life.
Šta znači večni život?
What does eternal life mean?
To znači besmrtnost.
It means immortality.
Bog će svoju besmrtnost podeliti sa nama.
God will share his immortality with us.
A mi koji smo smrtna bića, jedva to možemo i shvatiti.
As mortal beings, we can barely understand this.
Ali Bog daje.
But God is offering
On je dao sina svojega.
He gave his son.
A on će nam dati život večni.
And he will give us eternal life.
To je dar Boži.
It's a gift of God.
Koji Bog daje onima kao što vidite ovde, koji strpljivo čekaju.
Which God gives to those who patiently wait.
Da li se radujemo tom životu večnom?
Are we excited about eternal life?
To nije život na ovoj zemlji, grešnoj zemlji.
That's not a life here on this corrupted world.
Šta će mi život večni ovde u ovoj bedi i jadu kao što vidimo šta se dešava.
Why would we want eternal life here on this broken planet?
Ovo je život sa svetim Bogom i anđelima.
This is eternal life with the holy God and
Tamo
the angels.
Pravda živi.
Where justice reigns.
Nema zla I nema satane da nas muči.
There is no evil and no Satan to tempt us.
E takav život večni čeznemo.
That's the eternal life we want.
Hajde da razmišljamo još. Rimljanima 8:18.
Let's read Romans 8:18.
Pavle kaže, mislim da stradanja sadašnjeg vremena nisu ništa prema slavi koja će se nam u nama otkriti.
Paul says, I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us.
Zamislite, svi problemi na ovome svetu što ih imamo, ma nisu ništa kad se uporede sa darom koji će nam Bog dati.
All the problems that we face here on earth are nothing compared to what God has prepared for us.
Da li primećujete, nas očekuje slava.
Glory awaits us.
Šta je ta slava koja nas očekuje?
What is this glory which awaits us?
Ko je ta slava koju očekujemo?
Who is this glory we're awaiting?
Šta Bog, šta podrazumeva se pod tom slavom?
What does this glory mean?
Pa šta je to Bog obećao nama?
What has God promised us?
Da li to vredi? Da li se vredi boriti za to?
Is it worthwhile fighting to receive it?
A mi ćemo sada malo zaroniti u tu temu.
So let's go deeper into this topic.
Evo pogledajte šta kaže Filipljanima 3:21-22.
Philippians 3:20-21.
A naša otadžbina je na nebesima.
For our citizenship is in heaven.
Odakle iščekujemo spasitelja?
From which we also eagerly await for the Savior.
Gospoda Isusa Hrista.
The Lord Jesus Christ.
On će svojom silom kojom može sve sebi da podčini.
Who will transform our body that it may be conformed to his glorious body.
On će preobraziti naše bedno telo I saobraziti ga svom slavnom telu.
According to the working by which he is able even to subdue all things to himself.
Dakle, mi brinemo o našem telu, al tako?
We take care of our bodies.
Mi ne volimo što starimo.
We don't like aging.
Ne volimo sedu kosu.
We don't like gray hairs.
Jel tako? Ne volimo bore.
We don't like wrinkles.
Ali primetite, Gospod Isus nam je obećao.
But Jesus Christ has promised us.
Kaže, preobrazit će naše bedno telo.
He will transform our lowly body.
Kako je naše telo?
What is our body like?
Bedno, kaže.
Lowly.
Pa u odnosu na Adamu I Evu, kakvi su oni bili visoki I lepi, mi imamo bedno telo.
Compared to Adam and Eve, who were so tall and good-looking, our bodies truly are lowly.
To je greh učinio.
And that's what sin has
Ali
done.
Ali Isus će preobraziti naše telo.
But Jesus will transform our body.
Primetite ovde svom slavnom telu.
And he will conform it to his glorious body.
Kakav bude Isus, takvi ćemo biti I mi.
Just as Jesus is, so we will be.
Ovo je neverovatno.
That's quite incredible.
Ali to je obećanje.
But that's the promise we have.
Bog će nam dati specijalna tela, duhovna tela.
God will give us spiritual bodies.
Tela vaskrsenja.
The bodies of the resurrection.
Preobraženja.
The bodies of the transformation.
Neće to više biti krv I koža I kosti.
It will no longer be bones, skin and flesh.
Jer ima telo duhovno, kaže Pavle.
Paul
ima
says,
telo telesno.
There is a spiritual body and a physical body.
Ok, još očekujemo to telo.
So we are waiting this new body.
A na koga ćemo ličiti?
And who will we resemble?
Šta ćemo biti? U šta ćemo se preobraziti?
What will we turn into?
Naše bedno telo preobrazit će se u slavno, njegovo telo.
Our lowly body will be conformed to his glorious body.
Neverovatno je to.
It's amazing.
Zapišite stihove te I onda razmišljajte. Šta je Bog pripremio za tebe I za mene?
Remember these verses and meditate on what God has prepared for each of us.
Ko smo mi u njegovim planovima?
Who are we and how do we feature in his plan?
Šta će biti sa Hristovom crkvom, dakle, u večnosti?
What will happen to Christ's church throughout eternity?
Hajde da pročitamo ovaj silan tekst.
Let's read this powerful verse.
Sa njim nas je vaskrsao.
And raised us up together.
Posadio nas je na nebesima u Hristu Isusu.
And made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus.
Dakle, Isus je naš predstavnik.
Jesus is our representative.
I mi duhovno da kažemo smo već na nebesima u Hristu Isusu.
And in essence we are already up in heaven because Christ yeah. represents us there.
Što Bog čini sa Hristom čini će sa nama.
What God does to Christ he does to us also.
Ali šta će biti s nama u carstvu Božjem?
But what will happen to us in God's kingdom?
Pogledajte. Let's da bi read. U budućim vremenima
that in the ages to come,
to je ta večnost,
that's eternity,
pokazao preobilno bogatstvo svoje milosti,
he might show the exceeding richness of his grace
u dobroti prema nama u Hristu Isusu.
In his kindness towards us in Jesus Christ.
Dakle, kao što je na krstu Isus pokazao Božju ljubav,
just as on the cross Jesus showed God's love,
tako će Bog pokazati svoju ljubav na nama koji ćemo biti spašeni.
God will also show that love toward us who are saved.
Ali primetite, mi ćemo biti predmet opšte pažnje u svemiru.
But notice that we'll be an object of observation for the entire universe.
Jer će na nama pokazati preobilno bogatstvo svoje milosti i dobrote.
Because on us he will pour out and show the universe his grace and his mercy.
Dakle, celi svemir će gledati tu Božju milost i dobrotu na nama.
The whole universe will see God's mercy and grace displayed
toward us. I celi svemir će obožavati Boga zbog onoga što vidi šta Bog čini nama.
And the entire universe will worship God because of what they see him do to us.
Tako će se Bog proslaviti.
So God will be glorified.
Time što će on proslaviti one koji su prihvatili njegovog sina za spasitelja.
By glorifying those who accepted his son as their savior.
Prihvatajući nas, Bog u stvari proslavlja Hrista.
By accepting us, God is actually glorifying
Jer
Jesus.
Jer on je umro za nas.
Because he died for us.
Da bi nas spasio.
In order to save us.
Dakle, napregnite svu svoju maštu.
So, put all your imagination into use.
Pokušajte da proniknete to bogatstvo Božje milosti i dobrote.
Try to fathom the depth of God's gratitude
to još više.
And mercy, generosity
još
and mercy.
Više.
Go higher and higher.
Ali beskraj je iznad gore.
But you could keep going higher and higher forever.
Molite se da dođe taj dan što pre, pa da to doživimo.
Pray that the day will soon come when we'll experience this.
Hajdemo dalje. Rimljanima 8:17.
Let's move on to Romans 8:17.
Ako smo deca, a jesmo deca Božja,
now, if we are children,
onda smo i naslednici.
Then we are heirs.
Kakvi naslednici?
What kind of heirs?
Šta nasleđujemo?
What are we inheriting?
Naslednici smo Božji.
We're heirs of God.
S tim što Bog ne umire, pa nemamo šta da čekamo njegovu smrt da bi nasledili
except
njegovo bogatstvo.
God will never die, so we don't have to
ali
wait
smo
for that
naslednici.
But we are heirs.
I su naslednici sa Hristom.
And co-heirs with Christ.
Ono što je Hristos kao Mesija nasledio na nebu, i mi nasleđujemo zajedno s njim.
Whatever Christ as the Messiah inherited in heaven, we are co-heirs with him.
I kaže, ako zaista s njim stradamo,
if indeed we share in his sufferings,
da bismo imali udela i u njegovoj slavi.
In order that we may also share in his
sada
glory.
Krst.
Now the cross.
Tamo ću kruna.
And there the crown.
Sada kruna trnova, a onda kruna od dijamanata.
Now the crown of thorns, but later the crown
to
of diamonds.
To čeka iskupljenike Božje.
For those who wait on Christ.
Ovo je sad jedno čudno, a to je da ćemo mi spašeni zauzeti mesta Sotane i njegovih anđela.
Here's an interesting point, and it's this, that we, the saved, will take the place of Satan and his angels.
I Biblija kaže da je on trećinu nebeskih anđela survao u greh.
The Bible tells us that one third of the angels followed Satan into sin.
Ali Zaharija, prorok, nam kaže nešto zanimljivo.
But the prophet Zechariah tells us something interesting.
U svojoj zemlji govori Gospod.
And it shall be in all the land.
Istrebit će se i poginut će dve trećine.
Says the Lord, two parts in it shall be cut off.
A ostatak će u njoj biti jedna trećina.
And die, but the third
ostatak
shall be left in it.
Znate taj izraz ostatak?
The word in the Serbian is
crkva
the remnant.
Crkva Božja je ostatak.
God's church is the remnant.
Naučnici nam otprilike kažu da je do sada živelo negde oko 60 milijardi ljudi na svetu.
Scientists estimate that throughout history there have been about 60 billion people living on our planet.
Ne znam ja da li je to tačno.
I don't know whether
ali
that's
grubo,
accurate.
Ajde da jeste.
But let's assume it is.
A trećina od toga je 20 milijardi.
A third of that is 20 billion people.
Nije loše. Znači, za smrt koju je Isus doživio, da bar 20 milijardi ljudi bude spašeno
it's
kroz
nice
istoriju.
It's nice to think that Jesus' death could save even 20 billion people.
Ali ajde da čitamo šta kaže duh proroštva.
Let's read what the spirit of prophecy says.
Kaže, nebo će triumfovati slaveći pobedu.
Heaven will triumph for the vacancies made in heaven.
Jer će praznina nastala padom Satane i njegovih anđela biti popunjena iskupljenicima Gospodnjim.
For the vacancies made in heaven by the fall of Satan and his angels will be filled by the redeemed of the Lord.
Jer primećujete sada?
Are you noticing it now?
Dakle, praznina nastala na nebu pobunom Satanom bit će propunjena sa izbavljenicima Božim.
The vacancies made by Satan's rebellion will be filled by the redeemed.
Dakle, zato je plan spasenja.
So, that's why we have the
plan
of salvation.
Da niko ne propadne osim sina pogiblija.
That no one should perish.
Ali primetite, mi ćemo zauzeti te pozicije i ta mesta.
And we will take on the positions that given away.
Da li to možemo da zamislimo?
Can we imagine that?
Možemo li se radovati unapred ovome?
Can we rejoice that this will happen?
Dakle, kao što vidite, ta praznina će biti popunjena.
The vacancies will be filled.
I to je ono nešto vrlo snažno za sve nas.
It's very powerful for all of us.
Evo, pogledajmo još šta kaže Zaharija.
Let's see what else Zechariah says.
Ali pogledajte tu trećinu šta će Bog uraditi sa njom.
What will God do with this third?
Metnuću u ogan, pretopiću i kako se pretapa srebro i okušaću i kako se kuša zlato.
I will put this third in the fire. I will make them as pure as silver. I will test them like gold.
Jeste? Oni će prizvati ime moje, ja ću im se odazvati i reći ću, to je moj narod, a oni će reći, Gospod je Bog naš.
They will call out to me and I will answer them. I will say, they are my people and they will say, the Lord is our God.
Zašto će Bog pretopiti nas i okušati ko zlato i srebro?
Why will God put us in the fire and make and purify us as silver and gold?
Zato što to pročišćavanje će biti dokaz svemiru da je bezbedno da nas Gospod uzme sa ove zemlje i odvede na nebo.
Because this process of purification will be evidence to the universe that it's safe to take us from this planet and up to heaven.
Sada polažemo test.
Now is the time of our
test. I pred Bogom.
In front of God.
I pred anđelima na nebu.
In front of the angels in
heaven. Da li smo dostojni da zauzmemo tu prazninu na nebu?
Are we worthy to fill the vacancies in heaven?
I zato što god da ti se događa u životu.
And so whatever happens to you in life.
Gledaj to iz perspektive velike borbe dobra i zla.
Look at it from the perspective of the great controversy between good and evil.
To je jedan proces gdje nas Bog čisti.
It's a process in which God cleanses us.
Nemojte biti protiv tog procesa.
Don't oppose this process.
Bolje recite, Gospode, ne razumem kako to postupaš sa mnom.
You should say to God, I don't understand why this is happening.
Ali ti vjerujem da ja to trebam.
But I believe that I need it.
Ali vjerujem da će to biti za moju korist.
I believe that it will be beneficial for me.
Verujem da je to za budućnost moju večnu.
I believe it's for my eternal good.
U nevolji, u krizi, u problemima života pokažimo veru i oslanjamo se na Boga.
In problems and crises, let's show our faith and lean on God.
Jer Bog te priprema da jednom živiš među anđelima i među njima.
Because God is preparing us to one day live with him and with the angels.
Evo još jedno čudo.
Here's another amazing thing.
A Zaharija nam kaže,
Zechariah tells us,
ovako veli Gospod nad vojskama, ako hodiš mojim putevima i ako uzdržiš što sam vam naredio, da se drži.
Thus says the Lord of hosts, if you will walk in my ways and if you will keep my command,
tri stvari će Bog učiniti.
God will do three things.
Tada ćeš ti suditi domu mojemu.
Then you shall also judge my house.
Pavle nam kaže, mi ćemo suditi anđelima i ovome svetu.
Paul says, we will be judges to the angels and this planet.
Čuvat ćeš tremove moje. U hramu ćeš biti.
And likewise have charge of my courts.
I daću ti da hodiš među onima što stoji već u hramu.
I will give you places to walk among those who stand here.
Primetite, dakle, Bog priprema za nas nešto što će nas podići na nivo anđela.
God is preparing something for us which will elevate us to the status of angels.
I to su, vidite, te službe koje ćemo obavljati na nebu.
These are the services we'll perform in heaven.
I pogledajte šta kaže još Ellen White.
Let's see what Ellen White says.
Oni će kao grešna bića stajati pred velikim belim prestolom.
They will as sinful beings stand before
jedan,
the great white throne.
I primit će slavu i privilegije anđela.
And they will receive the glory and the privileges of angels.
Možemo li ovo zamisliti?
Can we imagine that?
Možemo li vjerovati ovo?
Can we believe that?
Bog će nam dati slavu i privilegije anđela.
God will give us the glory and privileges of the angels.
A anđeli su viša bića od čoveka.
The angels are higher beings than humans.
Njihove sposobnosti su skoro sve moguće.
Their capabilities are much more infinite.
U jednoj u deliću sekunde oni će proći od Božjeg prestola do tebe.
It takes them a fraction of a second to go from the throne of God
Sećam
to you.
Sećam se u mojoj trećoj godini studiranja na teologiji išli smo da držimo jednu evangelizaciju u selu Draškovići.
I remember when I was in my third year of theological studies, we went to do an evangelism in a town.
Baš sam ja propovedao te večeri.
And that night I was preaching.
Tri anđelske vesti.
On the three angels' messages.
I onda smo se vraćali nas desetak u kombiju.
And 10 of us were coming back in a van.
I pevali, bili radosni, znate.
We were singing, we were happy.
Evangelizacija, puno je crkva bila.
The church had been full for the evangelism.
I odjedanput.
And all of a sudden.
Znači u kombiju smo desetak
we're in the
nas.
Van, 10 of us.
Odjedanput naš kombi koji je išao ovako negde 90 na sat.
Our van which had been traveling 90 kilometers an hour.
Okrenuo se 90 stepeni i produžio.
Turned on a 90 degree angle and then continued going.
To je bila krivina, što mi kažemo lakat krivina, 90 stepeni maltene.
It was like a right angle.
Brat Čanji Laslo, pastor, vozio je.
The pastor was driving.
I kad je došao na 2 metra video da nema puta tamo.
And about 2 meters away he saw there was no more road.
I on nama kaže.
And he said to us.
Nisam ja, kaže, okrenuo volan.
He said I wasn't the one who turned the wheel.
Neko je okrenuo volan i mi smo nastavili putem.
Someone turned the wheel to save us and prevent us from going ahead.
Možete zamisliti kako smo slavili Boga.
You can imagine how we praised God.
Anđeli Boži su brži od stotinke sekunde.
The angels of God are faster than the fraction of a second.
Anđeli su svemogući, anđeli su brzi, anđeli su, šta ja znam šta sve.
Angels are powerful, they're fast and strong.
Ali Bog će nas podići na nivo anđela.
But God will elevate us to their level.
Ma da li je to istina?
Is that true?
Da li je to istina što vam sad pričam?
Is that true what you're saying,
Možda ja maštam.
Perhaps I'm imagining.
Pa ajde vidimo šta je Gospod Isus rekao.
Let's see what Jesus himself said.
Kažu za one koji će vaskrsnuti da više ne mogu da umru jer su besmrtni.
Nor can they die anymore.
Jer su kao anđeli.
For they are equal to the angels.
Oni su Božja deca pošto su deca vaskrsenja.
And are sons of God being sons of the resurrection.
Jer su oni kao anđeli.
Even Jesus said they are equal to the angels.
Zaista neverovatna Božja milost.
It's amazing what God's mercy can do.
Ali pogledajte, Bog ima još više darova koje će učiniti na nama.
But there is more that God wants to do for us.
U Otkrivenju 3:21.
Revelation 3:21 says.
Gospod Isus je obećao. Kaže,
God promised.
Pobedniku ću dati da sa mnom sedne na moj presto.
To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne.
Kao što sam i ja pobedio i sa svojim ocem na njegov presto.
As I also overcame and sat down with my father on his throne.
Danas je Isus na prestolu očevom.
Today, Jesus is on the Father's throne.
Ali za vreme milenijuma preokrenjuće se to i Hrist će imati svoj presto. Biće dva prestola.
But during the millennium there'll be two thrones. Christ will have his throne.
Ali Isus obećava nama da sedimo na prestolu.
And Jesus promises that he will grant us to sit with him on his throne.
A šta znači sedeti na prestolu?
What does it mean to sit on a throne?
Šta je radio car u stara vremena?
What did kings do?
Sudio je.
They judged.
Prosuđivao, sudio. I kao što ti kažeš, vladao je.
And they ruled.
Delio je neki, to jest ispoljavao je neki autoritet.
He exuded authority from the throne.
Šta znači da je Bog, da je Gospod nama ovde obećao da ćemo biti s njim na prestolu?
So what does it mean when God promises us that we'll sit on his throne together
Sećate
with him?
Sećate se u Otkrivenju kaže tamo da je Bog načinio nas da smo sveštenici i da smo carevi.
We know in other places in the Bible it says that God will make us priests and kings.
Vi znate da Danilo nam kaže da će zemlja biti isto carstvo Božje, ali i carstvo Božjega naroda.
And Daniel says that the earth will be God's kingdom and the kingdom of his people.
Za vreme milenijuma ispoljićemo autoritet cara kao sudije.
During the millennium we will have the authority of the king as judge.
Ali doći će još nešto više.
But there will be something more as well.
Pobedniku ću dati da sa mnom sedne na moj presto.
To him who overcomes, I will grant to sit with me on my throne.
Pa da li nam je neko u životu dao tako neko veliko, veće obećanje od ovoga?
Do we have any greater promise in life than this?
Da li vredi, dakle, verovati Hristu?
Is it worthwhile having faith in Christ?
Da li vredi uzeti ozbiljno Hrista za reč?
Should we take him at his word?
On je to obećao.
This is what he promised.
Ja bih bio srećan sam da budem spašen, što kažu neke vernici, ma u čašak tamo u svemiru da budem.
Some people say, I just want to be saved. I'll sit in a corner in the heavenly kingdom. That's
all I
want. Kaže,
stavit ću te na prest.
But God isn't content with that. He wants us to put us on the throne.
Ma je li moguće to?
Is that possible?
Pa zar nije moguće?
Of course it's possible.
Pa sećate se kad je Bog stvorio ovu zemlju, on je krunio se Adamu i Evu za cara i kraljicu ove zemlje.
When God first created the earth, he crowned Adam and Eve as king and queen of this planet.
I opet će to Bog učiniti.
And he will do it again.
Ali za razliku od toga, sad će učiniti malo više.
But he'll do more this time.
Proširit će malo više to.
He will expand it.
Ali sad ću vam to kasnije reći.
And we'll talk about that in a moment.
Pogledajte šta kaže u Hristovim pričama.
Christ's object lessons, it says,
ljudskim bićima koje teže za tim da obnove u sebi božanski lik,
to human beings striving for conformity to the divine image,
da to je pravo na najveće blago neba, na preuzvišenu čast,
there is imparted an outlay of heaven's treasure, an excellency of power.
Što će ih uzdići na položaj čak i viši od položaja anđela koji nikada nisu pali u greh.
That will place them higher than even the angels who have never fallen.
Šta sada mislimo?
What should we think now?
Ajde, da zamenimo ove pale anđele, razumemo to.
Okay, to fill the vacancies of the fallen angels. Okay,
a pogledajte sada ovo, stavljaće nas na poziciju veće i od anđela koje nikad nisu pali u greh.
But here we are told that we'll be placed higher than even the angels who have never fallen.
To će biti test za svemir, da li je spreman da prihvati tamo neke pobunjenike da budu u većoj časti čak i od njih.
That will be a test for the universe, whether they're ready to accept these rebellious people in a position even higher than unfallen beings.
Znate onu priču izgubljeni sin, jel?
We know the story of the prodigal
son. A onaj
son.
Drugi brat je bio ljubomoran što je otac primio ovoga bezbožnoga tamo.
The other brother was jealous that the father had accepted the son back.
Nebo je upravo nebo zbog toga što tamo nema ljubomore.
But heaven is a place where there is no jealousy.
Oni će se radovati Hristovom radošću.
They will rejoice with Christ's joy.
Što oni koji su bili ubice Sina Božjega su sada pomilovani i postavljeni na tako veliku poziciju.
That those who caused the death of Christ are now placed in such a position of honor.
To je nebo.
That's heaven.
A ovo je naša sudbina.
This is our destiny.
Vredi li da se borimo za to?
Is it worth fighting for it?
Vredi li da se možda malo i žrtvujemo za to?
Is it worth sacrificing for it?
Vredi li da upišemo naše ime tamo na ono spisak lanca molitve, da jedan sat bar provedemo u molitvi za Gospoda?
Is it worth sacrificing an hour or two of our time
ja
in a prayer chain? I think it's worth it.
Šta Bog čini sebi na slavu?
What God will do to glorify us.
Time Bog pokazuje da Satana nije imao ni jedan jedini razlog opravdani da se pobuni protiv Boga.
By doing this, God is showing the universe that Satan didn't have a single reason which could be justified for rebelling against God.
Bog time pokazuje da nema sebičnosti ni trunke u njemu.
God is showing he doesn't have a hint of selfishness in his character.
On kaže, one koji mene vole, ma daću im sve.
To those who love me, he says, I will give them everything, everything I have.
To je Božje srce.
That's God's heart.
To je Božja ljubav.
That's God's love.
Kao što je krst srušio obmanu satansku, tako će i ova dobrota Božja na nama održati celi svemir začuđen Božoj milosti i ljubavi.
Just as the cross destroyed Satan's claims against God, so these actions will show the universe
ali
who God truly is.
Ali će sada svemir videti da je Bog još nesebičniji, da je spreman da bivšim grešnicima da nebo.
The universe will see that what God is prepared to do for ex-sinners.
Šta je naša budućnost?
What is our future?
Bićemo na položaju veći čak od položaja anđela koji nikad nisu pali u greh.
We'll be higher than even the angels who have never fallen.
Verovali ili ne, to je istina.
Believe it or not, that's the truth.
Dakle, sa Hristom na tronu.
With Christ at the throne.
Gospod će nam dati krune, jednom ćemo proučavati o tim krunama koje Bog priprema za nas.
God will give us crowns and at a later date we'll study more about the crowns he's giving us.
Pa ne mogu da nosim krunu ako nisi kralj negde ili car kako.
You can't wear a crown unless you're a king or a prince
somewhere.
Čemu
služe te krune?
What's the point of the crown?
O, iza njih stoji autoritet i položaj.
The crown is a symbol of authority and position.
Hajde da razmišljamo još više o tome.
Let's think about it some more.
Ovde imamo šta će Bog učiniti sa nama. Pevali su pesmu novu pred prestolom i pred četiri živa bića i pred starešinama.
They sang, as it were, a new song before the throne, before the four living creatures and the elders.
I niko nije mogao da nauči tu pesmu osim onih 144.000 otkupljenih sa zemlje.
And no one could learn that song except the 144,000 who were redeemed from the earth.
Oni idu za jagnjetom kud god ono ide.
They are the ones who follow the lamb wherever he goes.
Otkupljeni su od ljudi kao prvine za Boga i jagnjeta.
These were redeemed from among men.
Dakle, primetite 144,000 zapečaćenih.
144,000 sealed people.
Po mom mišljenju, tu su milioni koji će se obratiti u ovo poslednje vreme.
I believe this represents the millions of people who will come to Christ in the last days.
Pogledajte, oni pevaju pesmu novu.
They're singing a new song.
Niko ne zna tu pesmu.
No one knows this song.
Ni heruvimi, ni serafimi, ni anđeli ne znaju tu pesmu.
Neither the cherubim nor the seraphim know this song.
Vi znate iz Biblije da serafimi obožavaju Boga, Isaija 6.
In Isaiah we read that the seraphim glorify God.
Al kad dođu spašeni sa ove zemlje.
But when the redeemed from this planet come.
Koji se nazivaju prvenci Bogu i jagnjetu.
Who are the first fruits of God and the Lamb.
Oni će sada preuzeti tu funkciju obožavanja Boga kroz pesmu.
They will take on the function of worshiping God through song.
Dakle, oni će sada, kao što vidite, biti tu i predvoditi celi svemir u obožavanju Boga.
They will lead the entire universe in worshiping God.
Da li možemo to da zamislimo?
Can we imagine that?
Oni to rade sada.
The seraphim
do
that now. A mi
kad dođemo, preuzimamo štafetu.
But when we come, we'll take on this responsibility.
To je zaista nešto neverovatno.
It's something amazing.
Kao da nam škripi u mozgu da razumemo to.
I wonder if our minds can even comprehend that.
Biblija kaže u Jevrejima da ljudi hrišćani sada koji dolaze u crkvu, oni su došli u crkvu prvorođenih čija su imena zapisana na nebesima.
In Hebrews it says to the general assembly and church of the firstborn who are registered in heaven.
A evo šta kaže duh proroštva.
This is what the spirit of prophecy says.
Oni koji Hristovom snagom pobede velikog neprijatelja Boga i ljudi.
Those who in the strength of Christ overcome the great enemy of God and man.
Zauzeće u nebeskim dvorovima položaj viši od anđela koji nisu pali.
Will occupy a position in the heavenly courts above angels who have never fallen.
Treba nam više dokaza o tome?
Do we need more evidence of this?
Dakle, evo, to je ostalo sad samo da verom prihvatimo.
All that we need to do now is accept it through faith.
Da se radujemo tome.
And to rejoice.
Kad dođe, ako dođe i progonstvo na nas.
Even if persecution
mi
comes.
Mi znamo zašto stradamo.
We know why we're suffering.
Mi znamo i zašto nas Satana tako mrzi.
We know why Satan hates us so much.
Jer on čita ove stvari, on zna.
He has read this, he knows.
I zato nas mrzi.
And that's why he hates us.
I učiniće sve da nas spreči da ne budemo naslednici Boži i Hristovi su naslednici.
He'll do everything in his power to prevent us from being heirs and co-heirs.
Ali to je Boži zavet, to je Boži amanet za nas.
But this is God's covenant with us.
I Gospod je pripremio to i čuva se to za nas, kao što kaže tamo
Petar. He has prepared this for us.
Zatim kaže, videh prestole na kojima su sedeli oni kojima je bila data vlast da sude.
And I saw thrones and they sat on them and judgment was committed to them.
U istražnom sudu, ko sudi na nebu?
In the judgment, who will be
the judges? Šta su, anđeli su svedoci, je li tako?
The angels are witnesses.
Imamo tamo oni 24 starešina koji su vaskrsnuli kod Hristovog vaskrsenja i Isus je poveo na nebo.
We have the 24
elders. Oni to rade u istražnom fazi.
And they're in the inquisitive phase.
Ali za vreme milenijuma promenit će se pozicija.
But during the millennium things will change.
Mi ćemo biti porota na tom sudu.
We will be judges at that.
I ispoljavati carsku vlast suđenja.
At that trial, and we'll be exercising the kingly power of judgment.
Isus će za svaki pojedini slučaj pitati nas, šta vi mislite, kakvu kaznu je zaslužio ovaj Lucifer ili ovaj anđeo ili ovaj ilon? Nas
će individual pitati. Case will be consulted as to what we think the punishment should be.
I kad mi kažemo, on će reći nek bude tako.
And it'll be as we say.
Hajde da pročitamo ovaj citat.
Let's read this quote.
Kaže, preimućstva onih koji pobede krvlju jagnjetovom i rečju svedočanstva svojega.
The privileges of those who overcome by the blood of the lamb and by the word of their testimony.
Kaže, prevazilaze moć našeg sadašnjeg shvatanja.
Are beyond comprehension.
Ne može to čovjek da razume.
We can't understand it.
To je iznad našeg razuma.
It's beyond our comprehension.
Bože ljubav, Bože milost je uvek tako, u stvari.
God's love and God's mercy are too great for us to understand.
Dakle, premudstva koje Bog pripremio za nas, pa ne možemo to da shvatimo.
We can't comprehend the privileges God has prepared for
možemo
us.
Možemo da verujemo.
We can believe.
Možemo da prihvatimo što nam je otkriveno.
We can accept what's been revealed to
možemo
us.
Možemo tako da hrabrimo svoju dušu.
We can encourage ourselves that way.
Ali uvek ćemo biti kratki za razumevanje.
But we'll always fall short of really understanding everything.
Pogledajte ovo, Luka 12:44.
Luke 12:44 says.
Istinu vam kažem. Postavit će ga da upravlja svim njegovim imanjem.
Truly, I say to you that he will make him ruler over all that he has.
Dakle, vi znate tu tu priču Hristovu.
We know this story that Christ
told. A vernom pristavu on tamo obećava da postavit ću ga da upravlja svim njegovim imanjem.
To the faithful servant, he says, I will make him ruler of all that he has.
Evo na engleskom jako lepo, naši srpski prevodi, hrvatski, svi isto prišu, ali na engleskom vidite imate malo razlike koje vam daju još više razumevanja.
And this is very clear in the English translation.
Šta ova priča govori Hrist? Šta tu Hrist govori?
So what is Christ saying here?
Nad kakim imanjem će nas Bog postaviti?
What will he make us ruler over?
I šta je uopšte to imanje?
What will we be ruling?
Hajde da razmišljamo o tome.
Let's think about that.
Znate ovo, svadba jagnjetova.
We know the wedding of the lamb.
Sve su ugravirana tamo naša imena.
Our names are already engraved there.
Čekamo taj moment i trenutak.
We're waiting for this moment.
Hajde da vidimo šta kaže Matej 25:21.
Let's see what Matthew 25:21 says.
Dobro, dobri, verni slugo, reče mu gospodar.
His Lord said to him, well done, good and faithful servant.
Bio si veran ili pouzdan u malom.
You were faithful over a few things.
Zato ću te postaviti da upravljaš velikim stvarima.
I will make you ruler over many things.
Uđi u radost sa svojim gospodarom.
Enter into the joy of your Lord.
Uđi u radost.
Enter into the joy.
Primetite kakva je Hristova radost.
We can see what Christ's joy
is. On se molio i rekao, oče, hoću da one koji si mi dao budu sa mnom gde sam ja.
He prayed to the Father saying, I want those who you gave into my hand to be where I am.
Ovo je praktično ispunjenje te Hristove molitve.
This is the practical fulfillment of Christ's prayer.
Šta je ovo veliko koje će nam Bog dati da upravljamo?
So what will God give us to rule over?
Okay. Hajde da vidimo šta nam kaže Božja reč.
Let's see what God's word says.
A on mu odvrati. Dobro slugo, dobri slugo, zato što si bio pouzdan ili veran u najmanjem.
And he said to him, well done, good servant, because you were faithful in a very little.
Bio si možda vođa subotne škole, vođa redara.
Maybe you were the leader of Sabbath school,
vođa
the leader of
tamo na parkingu.
The parking attendant.
Ali bio si veran u tom malom što sam ti dao.
But you were faithful in this small duty.
Imaćeš vlast na 10 gradova.
And so you'll have authority over 10 cities.
A onom drugom kaže, što je 5 zaradio, sećate se, a on mu reče, ti ćeš imati vlast na 5 gradova.
Likewise, he said to the other servant, you also will be over 5 cities.
Dakle, nećemo dobiti svi isto.
We won't all receive the
same
thing.
Mi mislimo svi isto ćemo na nebu dobiti, nije istina.
It's not true that we'll all get the same
thing. Ovaj će 5 dobiti samo gradova, a ovaj 10.
This one only got 5 cities, the other got 10.
Imaćeš vlast na 10 gradova.
You will have authority over
10
cities.
Kakvi su to gradovi?
What kind of cities
are these? Na nebu je samo jedan grad, Jerusalim.
Isn't there only the New Jerusalem?
A kakvi su ovi gradovi? Šta, o čemu to priča?
So what are they talking about here?
Hajde da vidimo i to.
Let's see.
Kaže u Isaiji 40, on je taj koji sedi nad krugom zemlje.
In Isaiah it says, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain?
Koji je razapeo nebesa kao tanko platno i razastro ga kao šator za stanovanje.
And spreads them out like a tent to dwell in.
Danas mi vidimo da je celokupna materija ovdje u svemiru bar nenastanjena. Nema uslova za život.
As we can see on our planet, there's only limited resources for life.
Ali Bog je stvorio to da to bude za stan, da se stanuje.
But when the planet was first, before God came to our planet, there was no way that we could have lived here. But
kada Isus bude stvarao novo nebo, novu zemlju,
but when he creates a new heaven and new earth,
on će popuniti te svetove u svemiru.
He will fill the other empty planets in our universe.
I naučnici kažu da svaki stanovnik zemlje ima na 7 milijardi. Možda
and
malo više.
Scientists say that every person on our planet,
dakle,
currently there are 7
svaki
billion.
Svaki čovjek na ovoj zemlji ima minimum milijarde galaksija u svemiru.
For each person on our planet there is at least a billion galaxies in the universe.
Evo ti vlast na 10 gradova.
So here are 10 cities for you.
Galaksije, konstelacije.
They could be galaxies, constellations.
A tebi na 5.
You get 5.
Neki će samo na zemlji biti carevi.
Some may rule only on the earth.
I stanovnici zemlje.
And will be citizens
of the earth. Ali ovi 144.000 idu gde god jagnje ide, idu i oni.
But the 144,000 go wherever the lamb goes.
Tako su radili na zemlji, sad tako će raditi na nebu.
As they did on earth, so they'll do in heaven.
Dobro je sada da čujemo i ovo.
So we need to hear this as well.
Da ne uzletimo, nego da se spustimo na zemlju.
To come back down to earth.
Hristos, samo Hrist i njegova pravda mogu nam obezbediti pasoš za nebo.
Christ, only Christ and his righteousness will obtain for us a passport into heaven.
Da, ovo je nasljedstvo svetih, kako kaže Božja reč.
This is the inheritance of the holy ones.
Ali ovo je totalno Božji dar milosti.
But this is purely a gift of God's mercy.
Svemir će zanemeti od čuda kad vidi kako će milost Bog izliti na nas.
The universe will be dumbfounded when they see the mercy that God will pour out on us.
A danas to treba da motiviše tebe i mene da zaista služimo Bogu svim srcem.
And today this should motivate you and I to serve God with our whole heart.
Hristos je pasoš za nebo.
Christ is the passport into heaven.
Moram ga prihvatiti za svog spasitelja.
I must accept him as my savior.
I drugo, njegova pravda me mora zaogrnuti.
His righteousness must cover me.
Da budem beo.
So that I'll be white.
Da budem čist u Božim očima.
That I'll be clean in God's
eyes. Da budem
eyes.
Prihvatljiv od neba.
That I would be accepted by heaven.
Da budem mala kopija našeg Gospoda Isusa Hrista
u
karakteru.
That I would be a small reflection of God's character.
Dakle, privilegija naroda Božjeg stoji van svakog uma.
The privileges of those of that God has prepared for us are beyond our comprehension.
Ali Bog nam je nešto otkrio.
But he has revealed something to us.
I to je dovoljno da nas motiviše.
And that should be enough to motivate us.
Isus poziva svakog od nas, dođi k meni.
Jesus invites each of us, come to me.
Ja sam taj koji ti želim dobro.
I am the one who wants good for you.
Ja sam pripremio za tebe predivnu budućnost koju ne možeš ni zamisliti.
I have prepared a wonderful future for you which you cannot even imagine.
Isus ide za nama i zove nas, dođi k meni.
Jesus is calling to us saying, come to me.
Dragi moji mladi, dođite Hristu.
Young people, come
on
to Christ.
On je bolji od vina.
He is better than wine.
On je bolji od seksa.
He is better than sex.
On je bolji od svake zabave koje ovdje na ovoj zemlji ima.
He is better than any entertainment this world has to offer.
Dragi stari, vi koji ste u mladim dobima isto, dođite Hristu.
Our other members, come
znam
to Christ.
Znam da razmišljate o svojoj plati, o svojoj deci, o školovanju i tako dalje, ali dođi Hristu.
I know you're thinking about your job, your children, your home, but come to Christ.
I draga starija braćo, znam da razmišljate samo o penziji ili možda o popravci ovome i tako, o staračkom domu.
To our elderly members, you might
ali
be thinking
Isus
about
kaže,
your pension, your health, but Jesus says, come to me.
Jesmo starci danas.
Today we are elderly.
Greh nas izopačio.
This is what sin
Ali
has done.
Ali milost Božja čini nas da smo sinovi i kćeri Božje.
But God's mercy makes us sons and daughters of Christ.
Kada Isus pitao Petra, zar nećete i vi odete od mene?
When Jesus asked Peter, will you not also leave
me? Petar kaže, pa gde da idemo?
Peter said, where do
we go? Ti imaš reči života.
You have the words of life.
Zato smo se prilepili uz tebe.
That's why we stay with you.
Niko to nije nudio što Isus nudi.
No one else offers what Jesus offers.
Bilo je onih u svetu koji su govorili, hajdete za mnom.
There were those in the world who called, follow me.
I neki su išli za njima.
And some people followed.
Ali su završili u jamu, u šumi, u živo blato.
But they finished up in a pit, in the jungle, in quicksand.
Ali niko kao Isus.
There's no one like Jesus.
Dođite k meni, kaže Isus.
Come to me, Jesus says.
Uspostavi jednu prisnu zajednicu sa mnom.
Build a relationship with me.
A večeraj sa mnom.
Dine with me.
I ja ću večerati s tobom.
And I will dine with you.
Pogledajte kakvu prisnu Isus želi sa nama.
That's the kind of intimacy Jesus wants with us.
To je privilegija tvoja i moja što smo danas isto ovo slušali.
It's a privilege for us
Milijarde
to hear
ljudi
these promises.
U ovom svetu uopšte nije ni čulo za Hrista.
Millions of people on this planet haven't even heard of Christ.
Skoro 3 milijarde ljudi uopšte nije čulo za Hrista.
In fact, almost 3 billion people have never
heard
of Christ.
A vi imate privilegiju da slušate i da ga verujete.
But we have the privilege to hear and believe.
Gospod poziva svakog od nas.
God calls each one of us
da dođemo k njemu.
To come to him.
Ne da mu služimo zbog ovih nagrada.
Not to serve him for a reward.
To je sebičnost.
That's selfish.
To nije pravi motiv.
That's not the real motive.
Nego što nas ljubi, što je umro na krstu za nas.
He wants us to love him because he loved us and died
for us. Radujemo se nagrada.
We are excited for the rewards.
Ali to nije u fokusu.
But that's not the focus.
Fokus je naš Gospod Isus.
The focus is Jesus Christ.
Biblija kaže on je sav ljubak.
The Bible says he is so loving.
Ako ga gledaš, ne možeš da se ne zaljubiš u njega.
That you can't look at him but then help loving
him. Pa on je kao zastavnik među 10.000 drugih.
I don't know what.
Prvi među.
He's the first among thousands.
A primetite. Gospod Isus je najveća vrednost našeg života.
He is the most precious thing in our lives.
Mene je Bog pozvao iz tame.
God called me out of darkness.
Bio sam mlad, 19 i 20 godina.
I was young, I was 19 or 20.
Na čudesan način je to uradio.
He did that in a miraculous way.
Pozvao me da budem njegov glasnik.
He called me to be his ambassador.
I evo, nakon 36 godina pastorske službe, nikad se nisam pokajao.
And after 36 years of service as a pastor, I've never regretted my decision.
On je mene izabrao od večnosti.
He chose me from before the beginning of time.
Ali ja sam njega izabrao.
And I chose him too.
Mojom slobodnom voljom.
With my free will.
Pogledajte kako je divan Hristos.
How beautiful is Christ?
A kako da ga ne volimo?
How can we not love
kako
him?
Da mu ne služimo?
How can we not serve
kako
him?
Da se ne žrtvujemo za njega?
How can we not sacrifice for him?
Toliko nas voli da je dao svoj život za nas.
He loved us so much he gave his very life for us.
Pa šta je to ako se malo žrtvujemo i mi za njega?
So what are some small sufferings and sacrifices
Prema
for him?
Prema onome što nas čeka, to nije ništa, kaže Pavle.
Compared to what awaits
Sve
us, it is as nothing.
Držim da je trice, da je, kako drugi prevod kaže, Trice, ništa. It's, Samo da Hrista dobijem.
Paul says it's as nothing if we gain Christ.
Brate moji i sestre, zovem te, prihvati Hrista.
Brothers and sisters, I call you to accept Christ.
U Hristovo ime te molim, prihvati Hrista.
I call you in the name of Christ to accept him.
Brzo će nas Bog zapečatiti, ko će ostati živ i dočekati ga.
Soon the time will come when God will place his seal on his people.
Vrlo brzo dolazi rešetanje u crkvi Božoj.
Soon there will come the shaking in the church.
Ako nas i 50% otpadne.
Even if half of us fall away.
Doći će drugi ljudi iz drugih crkava i religija.
Other people from other churches
Ali
will come to God.
Ali zašto da izgubimo tu poziciju koju sad imamo naroda Božjeg?
But why should we lose the position we now hold as the
Koji
people of God?
Koji je to greh? Koja je to radost u ovom svetu da nas odvoji od Hrista?
What on earth could possibly draw us away from God?
To može da se desi samo ako nemaš pojma o Hristu.
That can only happen if you don't know who God is.
Ako živiš u neznanju šta je to Bog pripremio za nas.
If you live in ignorance of the things God has prepared for us.
Ali mi nismo u tami, kazao je Božja reč kaže.
God's word tells us we're
mi
not in darkness.
Svetlosti.
We're in light.
Svetlosti sa krsta.
The light of the cross.
Svetlosti od Hrista koji ide ispred nas.
The light of Christ who goes before us.
Koji će provesti adventni pokret kroz sve te muke, nevolje i šta i učiniti ih pobednicima.
Who will guide the advent movement through all the troubles to victory.
Najvećim pobednicima koje svet ikad video.
The greatest victors that have ever been seen.
Odlučimo se za Hrista.
Let's decide for Christ.
Neka vas Bog blagoslovi u tome.
May God bless us in that decision.
Više i čvršće nego ikad.
More and more powerfully than ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Veličanstveni naš Bože.
Our glorious God.
Hvala ti što si hranio dušu našu.
Thank you for feeding our soul.
Hvala ti za ova velika preobilna obećanja.
Thank you for these wonderful promises.
Gospode, ti si grejo naša srca.
Lord, you have warmed our hearts.
Ti si sada kao magnet koji nas privlači k tebi.
You are like a magnet which draws us to you.
Tvoja milost, tvoja ljubav.
Your mercy, your love.
Je nesvatljiva.
Is shown to us each day.
Nesvatljiva na krstu, nesvatljiva u budućnosti.
Your mercy and love are incomprehensible at the cross and throughout the future.
Mi ne vidimo ništa u sebi da smo dostojni toga.
There is nothing within us which is worth this response.
Ali kroz to ćeš se ti proslaviti.
But through this you will be glorified.
I mi ćemo tebe proslaviti.
And we will worship you.
I odbraniti te od svih tih satanskih laži protiv
and we
tebe.
Will show the universe that all that Satan claims is a lie.
Gospode, ti si izabrao svakog od nas.
Lord, you've chosen each one of us.
Ali pomozi nam da mi izaberemo tebe.
And help us to choose you.
Molimo te, Gospode, pomozi nam da uvidimo tvoju lepotu i ljubav.
Please help us to see your beauty and your love.
Molim te, blagoslovi svaku osobu koja je ovde sada
Please
prisutna.
Please bless each person who's present here today.
I neka tvoj dobri sveti duh
and may your Holy Spirit
zapečati nas za spasenje.
Seal us for salvation.
Slava i hvala neka je tebi, Oče.
All glory and praise to you, Lord.
U ime predivno ime Gospodnje Isusa.
In the wonderful name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.